Welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. For this video, we're going to talk about how you can determine if a function is one-to-one. Now, of course, if we're going to determine one-to-one for functions, we first have to really look at what that means. We say that a function is one-to-one if every input goes to a unique output. And the way you want to look at this definition is it's like a little bit of extra criteria that we put on functions. So for a relation to be a function, you want to make sure that every input goes to one output, and this is just making sure that that particular output is unique. Nothing else goes to it. So to make this idea a little bit more concrete, let's look at an example of a function versus a one-to-one function. Here in a function, we have particular inputs, and they're mapped to particular outputs. And this is a function because every time I have a particular input, it goes to one output. Now, you may notice that down here, both the negative 3 and the 2 go to 4. Now, this is not a problem with being a function, but this type of situation makes it not a one-to-one function because we have two inputs that go to the same output. Now, let's go ahead and turn our attention to this guy over here. And again, you notice we have different inputs mapped to different outputs, but you know what? Every single input only goes to one unique output. That's what makes something a one-to-one function. Now, in practice, how do you really determine if something is one-to-one or not? Well, if you have a graph to look at, then you can determine if it's one-to-one by using the vertical and the horizontal line test. Each of these tests do something different, but let me see if I can break them down. If you use the vertical line test on, say, a relation, this is testing if it is a function, if every input goes to one particular output. When you use the horizontal line test, now you're checking those outputs to see if there's two inputs that go to the same spot. And the key with using either of these tests is that you either imagine a vertical or horizontal line, and you want to check to make sure that it does not cross in more than one spot. So let's use this test on a couple of generic functions and see if they are one-to-one. So here's an example. I have this function, or at least I have this relationship, and I want to test if it is a function. So you want to imagine a vertical line. And what you're testing is, no matter where you put this vertical line, does it cross in more than one spot? Well, you can see that, you know what, no matter where I put this vertical line, it only crosses once. So we can say, yes, this is a function. Now, to take a little bit of an extra step and say, well, is it a one-to-one function? Now we're going to use the horizontal line test and say, okay, if I put a horizontal line on here, does it ever cross in more than one spot? It looks like it does. So if it does cross in more than one spot, then you say, no, it is not a one-to-one function. All right, let's try this again with another generic function. Something like this. So first we could test it and say, okay, is this relation a function? Let's use our vertical line test. We're checking to see if it crosses in more than one spot. Doesn't look like it does. So we will say yes. Now let's see if it is one-to-one. So now we're using the horizontal line test. I'm seeing if it ever crosses in more than one spot. Looks like that is not the case. So we can say, yes, this is a one-to-one function. Now, it's really nice to have a graph and apply both of those tests. But sometimes you may just be looking at an equation, and you still have to kind of determine, well, is this thing one-to-one or not? If you don't have the graph, you can determine if a function is one-to-one by checking a particular output and seeing if it can be obtained from, say, two different inputs. Now, what this is really a test for is not if it is one-to-one for sure, but really a test that it is not one-to-one. So you're kind of looking for a counterexample that breaks it in some sort of way. So, for example, maybe I'm looking at this guy. F of x is equal to x minus 2 squared plus 3, and it does happen to be a function. But, you know, I'm curious, is it a one-to-one function? Well, here's one way that I can show that it is not a one-to-one function. I can test two particular inputs. For example, let's go ahead and test it out at 1. Let's see the result we get. So 1 minus 2 squared plus 3. That would equal a negative 1 squared plus 3. Or 1 plus 3, 4. So when I put in a 1, the output is 4. Now let's try for the 3. So we're going to put that in there as well. Let's see, 3 minus 2 is a positive 1. So it looks like we get the same output. So this is the problem that we're looking to avoid with one-to-one functions. I have one particular output, but two different inputs go to the same spot. So we say this is not one-to-one. That doesn't necessarily help as much with finding one-to-one functions, but it is a great way you can test if something is not one-to-one. So remember, the key here with determining if something is one-to-one is really by looking at inputs and outputs and figuring out if every input goes to a unique output. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.